So now, the fifth Sunday of Lent, the Gospel of John. A thick lesson for us this morning. If some of it flies over your head, that's okay. It flies over mine too. It's important to remember when we come into this kind of reading from the Gospel of John, that John's perspective in telling the story of Jesus is different from the other Gospel writers. The other Gospel writers, you know, tell us this story about a kid who's born in Bethlehem and who grows up and gets baptized, and the voice comes from heaven and commissions him, and then he goes on his way and he teaches throughout the countryside, and then he heads towards Jerusalem, and the drama builds and builds. What's going to happen in Jerusalem? And he has all these conflicts with the authorities, and there's a kind of political drama to it all. Well, for John, it's different. For John, right from the beginning, we know what's going to happen, and Jesus knows what's going to happen. Because for John, the Jesus event is an act of God. It's not the story of a guy who grew up into the fullness of a calling from God. It's the story of God made flesh. God come to the earth for a purpose. And that purpose will culminate on the cross. It seems to us, on the face of it, an odd purpose. But John is very clear about this purpose throughout the telling of his story. And we are now reaching a critical point. He has, just in the previous chapter, raised Lazarus from the dead. And for John, that's the big event which draws the Pharisees' attention and draws their determination to put him to death. It is as if they've heard about Jesus turning water into wine, and, well, we can live with that. Some guy can do a magic trick like that, that's okay. But when it comes to the issue of raising somebody, bringing back somebody from the dead, now that's truly terrifying. And it's terrifying to those Pharisees. And so it sets them in motion in terms of what they want to do to Jesus in putting him to death. That's come just before today's passage, and then, after that, has come his dinner in Bethany with Mary and Martha and Lazarus, and Mary has anointed his feet with oil, and he announces that what she has done is to anoint his body for burial. So he knows what's coming, and he's looking ahead to what that will be. And then we have today's story, and it starts almost casually. There were among those who went up to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover or to be there for the feast, there were some Greeks. It's a great line. There were just some Greeks there. A lot of people came there, and there were some Greeks, and why should this make any difference? And these Greeks, they'd heard about Jesus and what he had to say, and they want to meet him. So they go to Philip, who was from Bethsaida, which is a mixed community, so maybe they had some connection with him through that. And they say, we want to see him. And he and Andrew go to say, these Greeks want to see you. And what does he say in response? He says, the hour has come. Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. What is it? What is it about the Greeks coming that causes him to think that? Well, it's that the Greeks are from outside the culture and the community of Jesus' time. They are outside the whole establishment of religious rites at the temple. They're outside the structures of society that are there. They are elsewhere, and they have heard. They have heard the good news, and they are eager to know more about it, to encounter Christ. And that's what Jesus has been waiting for, because remember, repeatedly throughout the Gospel of John, Jesus has said, "My time is not yet. The time for the Son of Man to come has not yet come." He has said that over and over in terms of the Gospel of John, and now that he knows that power has reached beyond the immediate community, he knows now that it's time to complete his work. And remember that for John to complete his work, Jesus means for Jesus to be put to death on the cross. Because for John, the cross is a victory. Now, the other Gospels, it's not quite so clear that they can look and say, oh, that's a victory, that man being put to death on the cross. But for John, he's very clear. This is Jesus' victory over the powers of death. Because the whole theme of the Gospel of John is that God comes into the world to show the weakness, the frailty, the uselessness of the powers of death and corruption and violence that run the world.